Hey, Washington football fans. I am so happy to be back here, and I am so happy with the fact that training camp is finally here. And you know what that means? Football. 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 I don't think I've ever been so excited to know that preseason football, preseason NFL football is almost here. And in just another week or so, we are going to see our first action with the Washington football team led by Ryan Fitzpatrick going up against, I believe it's the New England Patriots. So that's going to be fun. I am so happy that football season is upon us. It feels like it's been way too long since we saw our last football game. Some news and notes from the last week or so. I know I have a lot to catch up on, and I'm sure that a lot of you have already heard a lot of this, but I just wanted to catch you up just in case you've been living under a rock. Starting with Jonathan Allen, wow, you know, he was definitely one of the leaders that we needed to make sure that we had a contract in place for him for however long. And so he wound up signing a contract for 4 years, a four-year extension worth $72 million. That's some good cash right there. I am just so pleased and happy that Washington is taking an opportunity to identify who their leaders are on this team and to make sure that we have them locked up for the long term. And Jonathan Allen was definitely one of those key components that we needed to make sure was going to be with this team, especially with that stout defensive line. We needed to make sure that Jonathan Allen was going to be around for the long haul. And certainly the other player that we have locked up is Logan Thomas, our emerging tight end who just had a breakout season last year with the Washington football team. He agreed to a three-year extension himself. It seemed like our tight end situation went from non-existent to suddenly we have depth, and starting with a solid tight end with Logan Thomas, and you know, just had a breakthrough year last year. And so I am so happy to see Logan Thomas getting rewarded for his efforts from last year. And I will also say, you know, a fellow Virginia Tech Hokie, I'm just so happy that, you know, he is on this squad. And you know, I'm just looking forward to a great season, hopefully season number two of greatness out of Logan Thomas. Now, training camp did start this week, and a few concerns, nothing really hugely major, but certainly concern as well. Of course, you know, Ron Rivera is talking about how that he really wants to see the numbers of his players who are fully vaccinated increase, and of course that's an issue. And you know, this week we've had three players to get put on that injured reserve list. Matt Ioannidis, he was put on that list. Curtis Samuel, and we got something else with Curtis Samuel in just a second. And also cornerback Chris Miller. Now Curtis Samuel, in addition to that, was also put on the physically unable to perform list because he had a slight groin injury, and so it's more of a precaution. It's nothing to really be super worried about, but yet there are some injury issues with Curtis Samuel, and of course, you know, also being on the what I like to call the unvaccinated injured list. So hopefully those players can get over this and get back. And that is definitely a concern for any football team, but certainly for the Washington football team, you definitely want to make sure that these players are vaccinated. I understand the whole issue with all of this, but at the same time, we don't want games being forfeited, and we don't want people not getting paid, right? That is certainly a concern, and I hope that this team continues to get vaccinated to a point where this will be a non-issue come time for the regular season. Heard a little bit from Chase Young as well. Chase Young blowing up Sam Cosmi, which is to be expected. The rookie coming in, you know, he's probably going to wind up getting a lot of playing time. And you know what? This is actually great news for Sam. Having to go against somebody like Chase Young in practice every single day, you know that's going to greatly improve Sam Cosmi. Chase Young certainly is at the point where he's mid-season form probably already. You know, we have no issues, no worries with Chase Young whatsoever. So it's kind of cool to hear about him just completely blowing up the offensive line. But at the same time, that offensive line is always a concern. So we want to make sure that Sam Cosmi is right there and ready to play, because I have a feeling he's going to get a lot of playing time this year. And you know, we were talking about Logan Thomas. Let's talk a little bit about Samus Reyes. Samus Reyes is balling out in training camp so far. You know, he's catching some long bombs. He looks like he is just ready to be the next great tight end. And I realize that's me probably talking with burgundy and gold glasses, figuratively speaking. Just the idea of having this depth at tight end is something that's going to be very valuable for us. And not only that, but it's going to also just create more offense, more versatility with the play calling. When you can bring in a tight end set on some of those shorter downs, or maybe those red zone plays where, you know, maybe you can't necessarily, or you don't want to necessarily put in a wide receiver package, or, you know, maybe it's not going to be a run play, maybe it will be, but, you know, you want your bigger guys in there. We certainly feel like having Logan Thomas, guy like Samus Reyes, you know, people like that, you want to be able to have those tight end sets. So I'm just, you know, certainly I know Reyes is probably a project, but I'm excited to see what he can do when he gets out in the field. Again, this is one reason why that I'm so happy we're having a preseason this year. We're actually getting to see these guys play. We may not see them play during the season, I don't know, but I'm just ready to see what Samus Reyes can do for us. And with what little I have seen so far, hey, the guy is working hard, and who knows, he may wind up having Logan Thomas as 1A, Samus Reyes as 1B, who knows. When people talk about the wide receivers, obviously they're going to gravitate more toward Curtis Samuel, Terry McLaurin, and maybe the newcomer Dyami Brown. But let's talk about Cam Sims. Cam Sims has continued to, well, I guess I would say he's picked up where he left off from last year. Cam Sims continues to be able to come down with contested catches. And yes, while there may be a concern with him not getting the separation, if he's still able to come down with the balls, then hey, that's fine, right? You know, he was one of my favorite wide receivers last year. Of course, you know, everybody loves Terry McLaurin. But Cam Sims really seemed like he came into his own, and I've enjoyed watching him play, and I think he's just going to continue to just improve this year as well, and he's really going to make it a tough decision, I think, for the coaches, because obviously we know that the coaching staff is not going to be able to keep every single wide receiver that is on the team right now. Now, I don't think that we're going to lose Cam Sims. He's definitely making a case to say, hey, I want to be here. I want to play in the burgundy and gold, and I want to continue to build upon what I was building last year. Now, I guess this is a good segue to Terry McLaurin. McLaurin has been lined up against William Jackson III, our number one cornerback, against our number one wide receiver in Terry McLaurin. And those two have been battling out big time in training camp. This is good news for us. You know, Terry McLaurin was certainly making some spectacular catches, I think, and just great overall. But, you know, William Jackson also was holding his own, having great coverage against our number one receiver. So, you know, both of those guys are just going to make each other so much better. It's kind of like the competition with Chase Young and Sam Cosmi. Of course, Cosmi is probably getting blown up right now, but he's learning so much. He's going up against a great defensive end. Same with Terry McLaurin and William Jackson. Both of those guys are tops in their game right now, and so you just know that it's going to make each other better. Competition breeds excellence, and good competition, solid competition, great competition is just going to make the team overall better. And so it's been fun watching some of the clips with those guys, and I just wish I was there in person to see it. And speaking of being in person at training camp, it's so nice to see fans being allowed back into training camp, being able to cheer on their favorite team as they practice. And I know that just probably just warms the heart of the players as well. I know some of the players have even commented on the fact that, you know, it's so great hearing those cheers, hearing them, that, you know, the fans just really get behind them, and just, you know, it's just so great having that atmosphere. Because I believe with all the changes that has happened in Washington, this will be the first time that I think the team, the franchise, will be able to truly see that, hey, these fans are coming back. And, you know, not only that, but just being able to have that support. You know, in years past, when you have games where you're playing against a division rival, even though you're out of the playoffs, but hardly any Washington fans are in the stands, and it was all Eagles fans, and you guys are knowing what I'm alluding to. We don't want to see that again. You know, even some of us who don't get to actually see some of these games in person as much as others, we don't want to see that. And I'm sure that when you're at the game, you don't want to see that either. And so I think having these fans come back to training camp to be able to watch these players play, it is just something that, you know, it's showing how much support that Washington has now with their fans, and just it's just an awesome thing. Finally, of course, Ryan Fitzpatrick. You know, Fitzpatrick, he's continuing to try to learn his wide receivers. He's kind of teaching them of where he's going to kind of anticipate where they should be at. He's throwing the balls into places and not trying to, you know, wait for the receiver to get open like some quarterbacks do. And, you know, as we all know, Fitzpatrick, if he knows that the ball needs to be thrown at a certain place, you know, a certain section in the field, and it's expected for the wide receiver to be able to run his route perfectly in order to be right there when that ball arrives, that's exactly what Fitzpatrick's going to do. And so that's going to be a learning process, and we're probably going to see a few mistakes early on, especially in preseason. But, you know, I would probably say that whenever you have a new quarterback trying to get, you know, used to his wide receivers, there's going to be a little bit of a growing pain, so to speak, in the probably the first few weeks of the season. But that's where a great defense comes in to hopefully keep the score low. So to give the offense more opportunities, and to also give them more opportunities to work out some of these kinks. And so I believe it's going to take a little while, but I don't think that there's any question that Ryan Fitzpatrick is going to go into week one as the starter. But now, you know, looking at Taylor Heinicke, he has certainly been balling out in training camp as well, and he's put on some muscle. That is the biggest knock on Heinicke, certainly, is his durability. So being able to kind of bulk up a bit, hopefully that's going to help his conditioning, that's going to help him to stay healthy and injury free, because I'm pretty sure at some point we will probably see Taylor Heinicke. I just hope, you know, being on the wishing on the optimistic side of things, I just hope that it's at a point to where it's because that we are so far ahead in the game that we can just sit our starters and let Ryan Fitzpatrick rest while Taylor Heinicke comes out there and kind of does a mop-up job. So, but other than that, it's so great to hear about Taylor Heinicke so far. He's balling out as well. Haven't really heard too much about Kyle Allen as of yet. I don't know. He, you know, could he be the odd man out? How many quarterbacks are we actually going to keep on the roster? And of course, Steven Montez, he's been working out. I think I've heard that he's been working out with the running backs. So they're going to try to kind of see if they can get Steven Montez in there, maybe not as a quarterback, but as one of those gadget type of players. I mean, it's great that if we're able to find a place for Steven Montez, even better. To me, with them trying to fit him into other positions rather than quarterback, he's probably not going to be a quarterback in the league. Like Tim Tebow, for instance, I wish that Tim Tebow had been willing to, you know, move to a new position, because I felt like he would have had a pretty good and successful career in the NFL. You know, and now it seems like he's actually doing that with the Jacksonville Jaguars. So who knows what's going to happen, but it'll be interesting to see what they have in store for Steven Montez. We are definitely going to need another quarterback, at least by 23. I don't think that it's just one and done for Ryan Fitzpatrick. I think that he is definitely going to be a guy who probably could play another 3 years. At that point, he will be over 40. I feel like at that point, you need to have your future quarterback in place. And I don't think that that future quarterback currently is on the team. So that's all I have for today, folks. So sorry for the absence of a couple of weeks. I posted in my community bulletin board, whatever you want to call it, just what's been going on with me in the past week or so. Now that training camp is here, I definitely want to make sure that I am reporting to you guys and giving you my analysis, and just, you know, as a fan, just being out here to support the Washington football team. And just, you know, just interacting with the rest of the fans out there. So with that said, hail to the Washington football team, and I will see you in the next one.